This video is all about the history of Ethereum. Ethereum's creator, Vitalik Buterin, originally wanted to extend the Bitcoin platform, but the core developers weren't interested in deviating from Satoshi Nakamoto's vision too much, so he had to create something new. Buterin created a more general blockchain that has emerged out of the successes of Bitcoin. Launched in 2015, Ethereum is the world's programmable blockchain. It increases what's possible with the platform. What makes it different from Bitcoin is that you can use it for lots of different digital assets, even Bitcoin itself. It is still digital money, but isn't tied to a specific currency. In fact, there are a multitude of uses outside of just currency exchange. Ethereum is for more than just payments. It's for games, applications, loyalty programs, learning programs, and more. Ethereum is an open-sourced, global platform for decentralized applications. It is also smart contract based. That means you can write code that controls digital value and runs exactly as programmed. Smart contracts code describes the rules for how your personal Ethereum blockchain should operate and who can participate. Let's explore the main benefits of Ethereum. You'll notice that many of these are the same benefits that Bitcoin provides. The Ethereum blockchain network provides accessible banking for everyone, privacy by not needing to provide your personal details and instead using your set of public and private keys. Ethereum is a peer-to-peer decentralized network that is censorship resistant. And what's more, Ethereum provides the ability to work with commerce and provides nice compatibility with other platforms and products. You can think of Ethereum as a Bitcoin computer. Ethereum has its own currency called Ether, but it also allows you to create your own cryptocurrency. If you want to buy some Ether, you can use a cryptocurrency exchange like Coinbase or Kraken. To get started, you can get some Ether yourself that you can use on different platforms and send some to others. To learn more about how to buy, I recommend going to ethereum.org/ETH. There you can find recommendations about how to buy Ether. You'll also need a wallet to manage your Ether and your Ethereum account, which will allow you to store, spend, and receive Ether. You can find out about how to sign up for a wallet at ethereum.org/wallets. Plus, there are many products and services built on Ethereum blockchain network. Those are referred to as DApps, which stands for decentralized applications. These are web and mobile applications that are powered by Ethereum smart contracts. To find out more about some of these applications, check out ethereum.org/dApps. Ethereum's blockchain network works much like Bitcoin's blockchain network. The blockchain is composed of millions of transactions. These transactions are grouped together into blocks. Each block has several transactions, and each block is chained together. For a transaction to be verified, it must go through the mining process where miners solve the current block puzzle and create a new block of valid transactions. A miner is able to solve the current block problem using the proof of work algorithm. When a miner validates a new block, they are rewarded with a certain amount of Ether. Currently, that amount is about 2 Ether, but this amount can continue to change and reduce over time. Transactions take about 10 to 15 seconds to be verified, as opposed to 10 minutes with Bitcoin. Where Bitcoin limits blocks to 1 megabyte of data, with Ethereum, you are limited to the amount of gas that you have. Gas is used to perform any operation on the network. You need gas for transactions. Just as a car can only go as far as the amount of gas you put into it, a contract will only execute up to the point of gas it has. This prevents people from running infinite or very computationally intensive tasks for which miners might not be compensated. The basic idea is that you need to pay for gas as you go. Ethereum is also Turing complete, which means that a program is sufficiently expressive and will have predictable behaviors. It also indicates that anything can be calculated, providing there is enough time and computing power. The part of the protocol that handles processing is called the Ethereum Virtual Machine, or the EVM for short. The EVM is a Turing-complete virtual machine. Ethereum also uses an expressive language called Solidity. This allows programmable smart contracts versus simple currency transfers that are allowed with Bitcoin. The code needs to be compiled to an intermediate bytecode representation, which can be executed on the different platforms. Each node executes the code and verifies the result. When a developer writes smart contracts for Ethereum, they typically write code in Solidity that is compiled and run on the Ethereum virtual machine. So that's the overview of Ethereum. Ethereum was built off of the ideas of Bitcoin, and it is wildly popular since it is a programmable blockchain and has many other use cases outside of just cryptocurrency transfer. At the time of making this video, the Ethereum core development team is working on Ethereum 2.0. This will essentially rewrite the platform and make it more scalable to move from a proof of work to a proof of stake consensus. This is exciting as Ethereum continues to improve and evolve over time.